Hello and welcome in our YouTube channel Metallurgical Facts. So in this video we will try to understand and we will try to understand the Griffith theory of brittle fracture, and we will do some numerical problems based on Griffith theory of brittle fracture. Okay, so this topic is suggested by one of our students on Instagram. He suggested that sir, please do the video on Griffith theory of brittle fracture, because many students have doubt regarding the crack lengths and many more things related to the units of units used in Griffith theory of brittle fracture. So we will try to understand the Griffith theory in this video. So before doing the numerical part, we will try to understand the Griffith theory of brittle fracture, and we will try to understand the formula. What is Griffith theory theory's formula? And we will not do the derivation part. If you have interest in derivation, you can go through the mechanical metallurgy by G. Ditter and find out the derivation. Okay, so derivation is not that much important for this for us for gate exam purpose or for RINL exam 2020. So we will see only the formula and the terms used in this theory. Okay, so according to Griffith, Griffith gave the elliptical crack model for finding the brittle fracture in material. Okay, so we will consider a wide sheet having a unit thickness of brittle material. Okay, so this is crack length of C. This is basically at the edges, okay, or we can say at the surface, and parallel to this we will have a crack of length 2C. okay, so whenever they will give the question, so we will see whether they have given the surface crack, edge crack, or interior crack, basically internal cracks. Okay, so the formula of Griffith theory is sigma f. This is basically fracture strength. Sigma f is equals to under root of 2e gamma, this is gamma, by pi c. Okay, so this is under root of 2e gamma by pi c. So I am writing here, what is sigma f? Sigma f is fracture strength. So whenever we will do the numerical of this Griffith theory, we have to careful about the units. Okay, so sigma f is having unit Newton per meter square. Okay, so this is basically the stress. E is elastic modulus, and elastic modulus have also unit of Newton per meter square. Okay, and this is gamma is surface energy. So this theory is also related by the stored strain energy, and from there we get the surface energy. Okay, the unit for surface energy is joule per meter square. Okay, and this is crack length. Basically we can write surface crack length. If we will write surface crack length, we won't have any doubt during the numerical part. Okay, so surface crack length we can write like that, surface crack length. Okay, so if they will give the surface crack length, we will directly put the C. If they will give internal crack length or interior crack length. Okay, so what we will do, we will take it as 2c. So if we will take 2c, suppose the internal crack length is 5, so we can find c value as 2.5. okay, so that will be equals to this c value, and we will directly put this c value in this formula. So we will able to calculate the rest of the values whatever they will ask in questions. Okay, so this sigma f we can calculate by putting the value of e gamma c, and pi we know this is constant, 3.14 value. Okay, so in this type of questions, whenever we will do, we will try to do with maximum crack length. Okay, we will try to do for maximum crack length. So suppose in any question, if they will give two or three crack lengths, suppose 2, 3, 4, so we will choose the maximum crack length for doing this type of questions, because this sigma f is inversely proportional to under root of 1 by root c. Okay, so this sigma f is inversely proportional to 1 by root c. In previous video I already told you that sigma f directly proportional to 1 by root c. Sorry, this is 1 by root c. So for the larger crack, we will have to apply the minimum tensile strength. Strength. Okay. So we will do. Try to understand these all these things by applying this formula on numericals. So how to approach the questions for this type of question for this type of problems. Okay. So now we will see the problems. So this is one type of question that may be asked from Griffith theory of brittle fracture. Okay, so the question is, a sample of glass has crack length of half length of 2 mm. So they have given that crack of half length. Okay, so we can consider it as a surface crack or edge crack, as because I have already shown in previous slides that that is the half length we use for surface crack or edge crack. The Young modulus for the glass is given, that is 70 giganewton per meter square. The specific surface energy is also given, that is 1 joule per meter square. So we have to estimate its fracture strength in megapascals. Okay, so we have to calculate in megapascals. So now we will see the formula, that is sigma f is equals to under root of 2 e gamma by pi c. So we know the terms of this terms that are used in this formula. So we will directly write the values that is given. So here they have given crack of half length, so we can write like that c is equals to 2 mu m, and this crack of half length can be considered as surface crack. Okay, surface crack or edge crack, as I have already told you that this surface crack is c value and the internal crack length will be 2c. okay, so this c is equals to 2 mu m, and this 2 mu m we have to change it, that unit in meters. Okay, because this surface energy is in joule per meter square and this is in giganewton per meter square. Okay, so this c is equals to 2 multiplied by 10 to the power 6 meters. Okay, so the Young's modulus of the glass is already given, that is e is equals to 70 giganewton per meter square. So we have to take in newton per meter square, so we will change this value also in newton per meter square. So 1 giga newton is equals to 10 power 9 newton meter square. Okay, so this is e value will be equals to 17 10 power 9. Okay, and surface energy we know, that is gamma is equals to 1 joule per meter square. We will put these values in this formula and we will get the answer. So sigma f is equals to under root of 2 70 multiplied by 10 power 9 multiplied by gamma, that is 1. This pi value is 3.14, and this c that is basically the crack length. So this is given in question, that is 10 to power 2 into 10 power minus 6. So we can calculate sigma c sigma f from here easily. Okay, so this is where the students do mistakes in calculation part. Okay, so we will do one by one in parts. Okay, so this is 140 10 to power 9, this is 3.14 multiplied by 2, and this 6 will go upper side, and this will 9 plus 6. Okay, so this sigma f we will find like that, this will come like that 22.29 multiplied by 10 to the power 15. Okay, or for finding easy square root we can write like that, so this will come easily, that is 10 to the power 14, and this will come like that. If we will take square root of this value, this will come like that 14.92 multiplied by 10 to power 7, and this will if we need to calculate in megapascal, so we can do like that 149.2 into 10 to the power 6. This is in newton per meter square. If we will take it is an megapascal, we have to remove this 10 to power 6. So the answer for this question will be 149.2. So the answer for this question is 149.2 megapascals. Okay, if they will ask in newton per meter square, we will write like that 149.2 into 10 to the power 6 newton per meter square. Okay, so we have to be careful for units. So as they will in what unit they will ask, we will write in that unit only. Okay, so the answer for this question is 149.2 megapascals. So the other type of question they may ask in exam, that is the two samples of A and B of a brittle material have crack length in a ratio. So they will give the ratio of crack length, or they will give the ratio of sigma value, that is fracture strength, and they can ask the crack length ratio or vice versa. Okay, so we know the formula, that is sigma F is equals to under root of 2 e gamma by pi c. Okay, and in this question they have given the data the samples that have c, the two samples, that is A and B of a brittle material, have crack length in the ratio, that is c a by c b. They have given that is 3 by 1. The ratio of tensile strength we have to measure, and assuming that every value is same for every other value, that is same for this question. Okay, so that is e value is e1 is equals to e2 is equals to e, that is constant. This gamma 1 is equals to gamma 2 is equals to gamma, this is also constant. So we can find the ratio, that is sigma f is directly proportional to 1 by root c. So we will find like that sigma f1 by sigma f2 will be equals to c2 by c1. Okay, so this sigma f1 by sigma f2 we can find like that under root of c2 by c1, means here we can write like that cb by ca. Okay, that cb by ca means 1 by 3. So we'll find sigma f by sigma f2 by 1 by root 3. So from here we can see this sigma f1 is to sigma f2 will be 1 is to root 3. So the correct option for this question is C part. So in this type of question they will simply give the ratio between two crack lengths. Okay, and they will ask about the fracture strength, or they can do the reverse of that. They can give the ratio of sigma fracture strength, and they can ask the ratio of crack lengths also. So we have to be careful for while choosing the material A and B, which one is first material, which one is second material, because if we will not do that, we will do the mistake here while applying for formula in ratios for finding ratios. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is C part, that is 1 to root 3. So the next type of question that may be asked from the Griffith theory of brittle fracture, that is a glass plate has two parallel cracks, one of them is an internal crack of length 5 mm, that is micrometer, and other is a surface crack length of 3 mm. A tensile stress is applied perpendicular to the crack surface. So already I have shown the figure for in the first slide, the fracture stress in megapascals. Okay, so megapascals we have to find the fracture strength. The given data are Young's modulus and surface energy. Okay, so we will write like that. We know the formula, that is sigma f is equals to under root of 2 e gamma by pi c. Okay, and the given data for this question is they have given the internal crack length, that is 2c, that is 5, and 1. This is, I will assume that 2c1, and this is c2 value they have given 3, that is in micrometer mu m. Okay, so this is the crack length they have given, and So for this type of question, when they will give the mixtures of two both the cracks, that is a few of the surface cracks and few of the internal crack length, we have to change the internal crack length into the surface crack length. Okay, so if we will change 2C by 5 mu m, so we will get C1 value, that is 2.5 mu m. And I have already told you that whenever we will apply the Griffith theory, we will work for maximum crack length. We will work for maximum crack length, because as we will apply the fracture stress or the critical stress or the tensile strength, that crack will propagate the first which were having the highest crack length. Okay, so that we will work for maximum crack length every time. So no matter, in this case they have given only one internal crack, they can give maybe four or five internal cracks or four or five surface crack lengths, and they can give the mixtures of both the crack lengths. But we have to, every time we have to change the internal cracks into the surface crack, and we have to compare which one is the largest one, which one is the maximum crack length, and we will do the question for that only. Okay, so for doing this type of problem, we will choose the maximum value of C. So in this case, the maximum value of C is 3 mu m. So we will work for 3 mu m. So don't forget to change internal crack length into the surface crack length while comparing these type of questions. So this is the mistake generally we do in the exams, generally the students do in the exams. So we have to be careful for maximum crack length. So sigma f we can write like that, 2 e value. E value is 70 GPa, that is gigapascal, that is GPa. So 70 multiplied by 10 to the power 9. Gamma value is 1 joule per meter square. So 1. Pi value is constant, that is 3.14. And C value we will take 3 micron meter, so that is 3 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 6, and we will do the calculations for this. So we will get like that, 14.86 multiplied by 10 to the power 15. So we will get, if we will take the square root of this value, we will get like that, 12.19 multiplied by 10 to the power 7. So we will get 2121.9 into 10 to the power 6. This is in Newton per meter square, and in question they have asked in megapascals. So we will remove this 10 power 6, and we will write like that, 1 to 1.9 is the answer in megapascals. So we'll write here 1 to 1.9 megapascal is answer for this question. Okay, if they will ask in Newton per meter square, we will write 1 to 1.9 into 10 to the power 6 Newton per meter square. So in this type of questions, only thing we have to be careful that we will always choose the maximum length from all the surface crack lengths while comparing. Okay, because I already told this sigma f depends direct depends on c value. Okay, so we will do like that. So the answer for this question is 1 to 1.9 megapascal. So this type of questions I think were frequently asked in the GATE exam, and also in RINL exam they can ask this type of questions. So be careful for with the units that is used for brittle fracture, and also the crack lengths. Thank you guys for your attention. Hope you have learned something new in this video. In this video we have told the Griffith theory of brittle fracture. So this is very important topic in mechanical metallurgy, and in any exam of metallurgical engineering you will get one question from this part, because of because only because people get confused in crack lengths. So whether we have to choose internal crack length or whether we have to choose surface crack length, or sometimes they do silly mistakes in changing while changing the units, while conversion the conversion of units. Okay, so be careful for this type of questions. Subscribe our channel and press bell icon to get notification for upcoming videos. Thank you.